Welcome, everyone. I do not have a mic, so I'm going to belt it out. You are all so quiet. I was just in the theater with 75 little people watching The Grinch, and it was like mayhem. So this is very good for me. Breathe. Welcome to the 36th annual Messiah-Sing. My name is Alita Wilson. I'm the executive director of Pentangle Arts, and we are so thrilled to have you here at the end of what has been certainly a weather-interesting wassail weekend. The squalls out there right now are interesting as well. I want to thank Father Mike and his parish for welcoming us back to this very special place. And to Elizabeth Romano, I don't know if you're here, Elizabeth, but she provided food, a lovely lunch for our artists. Thanks also to Opera Company of Middlebury and Lisa Willems for their assistance in bringing together an amazingly talented group of vocalists and musicians. We are thrilled to continue our free classical series at Pentangle. If you value this tradition, we ask that you make a donation if you have not in the baskets in the rear. In addition, many of you may know that efforts are underway to rebuild the organ here at Our Lady. Pentangle will donate $100 from the donations received today to help that important work continue, and we urge you to support that effort as well. Now please join me in welcoming our conductor, new this year, Mary Westbrook Gia.
I live in Westminster, just north of Putney. I do a lot of my musical work down in that area. I conduct the Blanche Moise Chorale, which is a program of the Brattleboro Music Center. I teach at Marlboro College, but not for long. And I have private students, and I'm the music director at the Dummerston Church. I'm really happy to be here today. Very excited. It's nice to see this beautiful church packed to the gills. Handel's Messiah first performance was in Dublin, Ireland. He wrote the piece in 1741, and the flyers that went around Dublin advertising the premiere anticipated an audience like this of people crammed in. And the flyer actually said, "Please, gentlemen, leave your swords at home. And ladies, no hoop skirts." So I'm glad to see that you've complied with that. I also have to tell a story on my older daughter. My younger daughter's here today. My older daughter's out in Los Angeles. But when they were little, I sang so many performances of Messiah, it wasn't even funny, right? It was a big piece of our bread and butter in my family. A lot of them were in Boston. And there was one particular Christmas that I think between Thanksgiving and Christmas, I sang about 18 performances of Messiah. And I was going out the door in a dress every night. And after maybe 10 or 12 of them, my older daughter, Maggie, said, "Mom, are you going to go sing that Halloween chorus again?" I love this piece. I have done it a lot, but I'm afraid it's everything it's cracked up to be. It's a great piece, and I'm so happy that you're here today to share it with us. Welcome and enjoy. Sing, right?
Yes.
Okay, so when it's time, I'll tell you, okay? I'm going to turn around and see if I can juggle two scores here. Okay.
Thank you. Oh, yeah.
You're on standby, right?
Thank you. Thank you. Then shall the lame man